Good to see you.
Yeah, nice to see you too.
All right. You're getting ready to fight for another world title. Second division that you're going for a world title shot. You captured a belt at 26, vacated. Now you're up at 130. You've been here for quite some time. You knew this was coming. You earned the mandatory position. Let's first talk about the opportunity to win a world title in your second weight class.
It's definitely an amazing opportunity. We back here, back again, fighting for another world title. My last world title I fought in October. This world title I fight in October. It's going to be no different. I'm coming in to dominate. Jamel is a solid fighter. He got a great team around him, but it's going to be my night. That's how I feel. So.
Your thoughts on fighting here in Atlanta, State Farm Arena. It's a place, like Bob said, is becoming another hotbed for boxing. Just the opportunity to expose your skills to a different audience here in the South.
Yeah, I mean, this is my type of audience at the end of the day. So I love Atlanta. My mother used to live in Atlanta, so I came here a lot. This is definitely my type of crowd, so I'm definitely going to try to be a crowd pleaser, try to put on the best performance that I can, and I'm going to show up.
Speaking of being a crowd pleaser, I know talking to you after the fight last time, you weren't thrilled with your performance. That's fair to say, right?
Yes.
So with that being said, what could the fans that are purchasing tickets tomorrow to join us in Atlanta expect from Shakur? Obviously different opponent, different stakes, but what can they expect from you to bring? Something a little bit different?
I think they should expect a superstar to be born at the end of the day. I feel like Jamel Hammond is a solid fighter. The better the fighter is, the better I get. So I feel like he's going to try to come in there, turn me up, and I'm going to turn up.
And much has been dubbed in this promotion, you know, when friends become enemies, or, you know, putting your friendship aside. But you've kind of said friends with the eye emojis, more like acquaintances. How would you kind of describe your relationship with Jamel? I mean, you guys share nutritionists, you share publicists, you've been in the gym together. But in your own words, so you can put out there, how would you describe, you know, the status of your relationship with him?
He's just a friend of my family at the end of the day. He's not my friend. He's not nobody I talk to outside of boxing. We don't got no relationship outside of boxing. So he's somebody I see around, and he mess with the same people that I mess with. But other than that, we not friends. I never really been his friend. He's cool people. I don't got no problem with him at all. But it ain't like I check up on him whenever I'm not fighting, or he check up on me. So I don't consider that a friend.
So it's all business once you step inside the ring and then afterwards?
Yeah, it's definitely business. Afterwards, it is what it is. We could go out and eat, or we could go out to a club or something. I don't mind. But at the end of the day, I'm coming here to handle business, and I'm going to make sure I win.
All right. Thank you, Shakur. Appreciate you. And we're going to... Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Because it's Elie Seckbach.